You're not recording. Hello. Hi. We're just laughing because, you know, we're not techies and we're recording a workshop.
Welcome to our presentation.
Yeah. Hi, I'm Paul Ricciardi. I'm an associate professor of theater at Kingsborough Community College.
And I'm Michelle Turnbull, who has a very unique experience of having been in the high school world and now is making the transition into the college world.
Yeah. Yeah. So we just want to do a quick overview before, and I apologize in advance. I'm looking this way because my script is over here and you're here. So I just want to make sure I'm saying everything I want to say. I just want to say a little bit more about myself just to give you a little context, then Michelle will, and then we'll dive right into it. So I'm a full-time theater professor at Kingsborough Community College, and I'm also a course coordinator for College Now, which is an early college program at Kingsborough Community College. Michelle will talk a bit more about that in a bit. And then, so what we're going to do today is, in general, we want to tell you the story of how we, Michelle and I, who are co-coordinators for a Humanities College Now course. I live on a truck route. That was a truck that just went by at Kingsborough Community College. So we want to tell you the story of how we created an OER for humanities course with the College Now program at Kingsborough Community College. So we will talk a little bit about sort of the what inspired us to do this, the sort of coming up with a solution to a problem,
and then process.
How we went about and the process, talking about how we went about doing it. And then we're going to share with you the OER text that we created. Did I get that right,
Michelle? I think that's perfect.
Okay.
All right. So you know who Paul is. I'm Michelle. Yep. Basically, I taught high school English for 14 years of my life. And during that time, I got involved in this College Now program through Kingsborough. So basically, Kingsborough offers college courses to students while they're in high school. So they're earning college credit. They're saving money. They're getting kind of this intro to college to see what it's like. It's really a beneficial thing to our students. So for many years while I taught high school, I taught this humanities course that we're now coordinating. So I understand what it's like to be on the teacher end of it. And now as the coordinator, you know, trying to help the teachers with their courses.
Yeah. Yeah. And it was interesting. Michelle and I started co-coordinating this class right when you transitioned from teaching to coordinating the program. So we kind of started together.
And then the pandemic hit.
And we'll talk more about that later.
Yes.
But before we dive into the process, I just wanted to also talk about, so Michelle talked a bit about, and she'll talk a bit more about College Now and what it is, but I wanted to tell you a little bit about Kingsborough Community College. So Kingsborough Community College is part of the City University of New York system. It is located on Manhattan Beach in Brooklyn, which is at the very southern tip of Brooklyn. So kind of near Brighton Beach and Sheepshead Bay in that area. We have an extremely diverse student body. 75 different languages are spoken, over 100 different countries are represented. A lot of our students are coming from homes that are living at or below the poverty line. So a lot of our students are coming to college for free. And many of our students are first generation college. And then I just think this is an interesting detail. Most of our students pre-pandemic were commuting well over an hour and a half to 2 hours every day to get to school. So I think that's just sort of an interesting piece to put into the puzzle. But that's just a little bit about Kingsborough Community College. And now Michelle's going to say a little bit more about College Now.
Well, I think just to your point, but like that's why this OER is so important, right?
Yeah.
Because
yeah.
First of all, textbooks, like how, I mean, we'll get into that, but so College Now. So basically what Kingsborough does is they hire high school teachers as adjuncts as faculty of Kingsborough to teach these college classes in the high school setting. So they always told us it's like Kingsborough is renting space in the high school to teach this course, right? The kids get a Kingsborough transcript. They get access to the Kingsborough library, all these college amenities. They can actually use the campus. There's also a beach. Paul mentioned we're on the beach, so there's like this private beach. So there's a lot of benefits, and it's really great for the students, not only because they earn the college credit for free without having to pay all the fees and pay for the textbooks, but I always told my students it helps them get into college. These are students who might not be in an AP class or advanced honors classes. So this is a way for the colleges to see that they have the abilities to succeed in college. And there's so many courses. We do college writing, they have communications, obviously humanities, there's business courses. They also offer, Kingsborough has like these amazing college now courses that the kids can take on the weekends. One of them is like culinary.
Yeah. Which is amazing. Theater. I actually couldn't coordinate another theater arts course. Yeah, it's really kind of extraordinary.
And what about the maritime one where we have a boat and the kids can take these courses on a boat?
Yeah, it's really
great. Kind of amazing.
Should we jump on to the why? Sure. Am I jumping ahead or is that right?
No, let's do it.
All right.
So so this is the problem that we encountered. I'll never forget, we were having a College Now meeting with our director. And she told us that the textbook budget was $0.
Right.
And I think I laughed, like thinking, oh, okay, zero. But she was like, no, I'm serious. There's $0. So as the coordinator, in my head, I'm like, well, if we have a teacher who has 25 textbooks and 30 students in the class, how are we going to get them those extra couple of textbooks if there's no money? So then, I don't know if you want to talk a little bit about the process. Like, we actually met with the publisher of our textbook to see if there was an online version. Like, we're remote, let's switch to online. Maybe it'll be cheaper. And he was giving us a great deal, but it was still too much money to be spending on textbooks.
It was really a conundrum. So we had gone, you know, COVID began. All of the public schools in New York City were remote. All of the City University of New York was remote. All of our faculty were teaching these classes and they had no access to the book. Like, so it was a real conundrum. And even if we had the money for a book, we didn't have any wherewithal to mail the book to them. I mean, that was really part of the issue. You know, even before really wrapping our minds around what an OER even was, we were just trying to figure out how can we get this digital copy without breaking copyright laws to our faculty.
Absolutely. And then we found out about OER. So we were like, great, let's find an OER text for our course.
Right.
And we couldn't.
Yeah. So what was interesting is, you know, Michelle mentioned before, the college now has courses across the spectrum. So I also coordinate a theater arts class, and we do have an OER, it's an Introduction to Theater Arts text. And for those of you that are just kind of new to the OER world, it's a whole world out there. So you can just Google OER Introduction to Theater Arts text, which is basically what we did. And it popped up. There were several, and we were able to find one that kind of fit our, you know, pedagogical approach, and we were using it. Mm-hmm. And I really, so I just assumed it would be really easy. I said to Michelle, I said, well, let's just find an OER humanities text, like the one we got in theater. Yeah,
I think, and the issue with our course is it's not like a traditional, you normally these humanities courses, they're like in classical ancient Greece and the Renaissance, but our course is so specific to modern day, right? We only focus on 1900 onward.
Yeah.
So it was impossible to find this very specific OER text. So then Paul was like, let's just make it ourselves. And I was like, what?
But there were a couple things that were sort of working in our favor. Kingsborough Community College has an OER coordinator. And so so we were able to meet with the OER coordinator, and we actually got a little financial support to sort of support this process. And we'll talk a little bit more later about how we developed the OER. So we did have some support at the college once we realized that a humanities OER did not exist, or at least one that fulfilled the approach that our course took, which is really sort of a 19th, 20th century overview of the arts and humanities and how it impacts our culture.
Yeah, you know? And you always say, like, we have to ensure the course requirements are being met, right? And I think the only way to do that was to kind of find the different texts that we needed ourselves.
Yeah,
so,
which is what we did. Yeah. Should we move on?
Sure, yes. So how did we do it? well, I think it definitely was a unique collaboration. We were like a motley crew of individuals. Yeah. You have me, who's a high school teacher, now transitioning to college. We have you, a college professor. That is your, you know. We had one teacher whose focus was special ed, which I actually thought was really interesting, because one of the benefits, obviously, of OER is that you can kind of adapt and change parts of the text. So what the special ed teacher did with the OER text was he was able to kind of put in definitions to vocabulary and change some of the wording, make it more digestible. So that was really good. And then we had high school English teachers. We had the OER coordinator at Kingsborough. We were like,
it was really, I mean, the process was really kind of extraordinary, actually. And just to back up a little bit. So Michelle and I were able to get some money from the OER program at Kingsborough Community College to pay four of our College Now Humanities faculty members. These are teachers who are out, you know, in the field teaching at the various schools. And each one of them, and Michelle will talk more about this in a moment, and then Michelle and I picked up pieces too. Each of us, the Michelle and I and these four faculty members, each took sort of a chapter basically, or a section of the book, and started doing research. Did I explain that right?
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Yeah. I started just with our syllabus, right? What did we need? And I divided it up. And once we had the faculty on board, because we had this grant money, right? I think a lot of it is, if the teachers have a hand in making it, they're more likely to use it, right? We wanted them to be willing to use this new textbook that we were creating. Yeah. So once I kind of split up the syllabus and the curriculum, and I, you know, into different pieces, and I said, pick which one you want, which one speaks to you the most, which topics are you most passionate about, and we assign them topics. And then we had to start to find where do you even start? So I'll just quickly toggle to this slide here. So this is how we started, right? I gave them a list of these websites and said, start searching, right? If your topic is Vietnam, here, try and find some OER Vietnam stuff. If you're working on 1920s, Great Gatsby, here you go. Try and find things that relate to that topic.
Once you kind of started, so we were looking at other OERs to get material for our OER. And it was really inspiring. I did, in a moment, we will show you the text, but I was looking for information. I ended up doing two sections, one on theater and then one on sort of queer history and context. And in both cases, I found texts where the people who mixed these texts were really clear, saying, use it. We're doing this to share. And so it was a really kind of, there was a generosity of spirit once you kind of dove into this world that was really exciting to me.
Absolutely. And that was, I think, well, we'll get to the challenges in a minute, but you know, it was really important that we really try and make it a full OER, right? Where we can kind of edit what we need and take pieces and edit here and remove what we don't need. So I think that there was a lot of challenges with that, specifically because we're like this modern art, finding the public domain images for the artwork.
That was
a huge, I mean, the law, I think it's like, it becomes public domain 70 years after the artist's death.
Yeah.
So if I need 1960s pop art, we're not quite there yet.
Yeah, that was really tricky. And some of the estates had released it. But that was really hard because we kind of thought we were done. You know, we had gotten really far into the sort of layout process, and Michelle did all of the laying out. And all of a sudden, somewhere along the line, we met with our OER coordinator at Kingsborough, and she kind of flagged it. She was like, guys, you need to deal with these citations for the photos as well. So we had to kind of double back, check all of the citations for all of the artwork. And we'll show you the text in a moment. It was a lot of checking.
Of course, making it more accessible, right? Another benefit to this OER is the access it has for all. So if you're adding the alt text to every single image that we have, and this is a very art heavy course, it was very humbling because I really had to think about, well, how do you describe a Picasso painting to someone who's never seen a Picasso painting?
Yeah.
You know, this was like one of the big challenges, I think.
Yeah. Yeah. And excited. It was so exciting. You know, but neither one of us knew anything about this beforehand. So it was really.
It was definitely a learning curve. Okay. So let's show them the finished product.
If you stop sharing, then I'll go ahead and share my screen. Let me just make sure I have the text.
So while Paul's pulling it up, it kind of lives on this CUNY website, CUNY Academic Commons. We wanted it to have a website so that when the teachers are using it, it's very easy for the students to pull it up on their phones or their tablets, very easy to access it in class. So it currently lives just on a website. But when we talk about our next steps, we have a lot of goals as to where we would like to see it live. Yeah.
Michelle, can you see my screen?
Yes.
Excellent. Okay.
Beautiful.
So just want to give everyone a little tour. It's, you know,
our baby.
We're really proud of this. So, you know, the way we organize this is, you know, the birth of modernism, the jazz age, the search for meaning, and the beginning of globalism, liberation, and equality, 1960 forward. So starting, at the beginning of 1900s and then moving through to the century. And I just want to kind of give you, let me just toggle out of this for a second because it's easier to navigate that way. Let me take you, just because I had a hand in it and I understand. Let's go to page 133 for a second. So the book, we tried our best to create a text that had images to sort of reinforce what the students were learning. So here we are there. So we're in the Vietnam era. And so with all the sort of the protests and the uprising of the 1960s, you have Black Power moving on, and then women's rights. And then we included a chapter which I mixed on LGBTQIA+ history. There's Ma Rainey talking about representation. Stonewall, AIDS activism. And so you can see, you know, we did these images that Michelle was talking about. You know, we wanted to balance, images with text. And then, you know, one of the things that I love so much about this textbook is the fact that it's really putting the artwork into perspective, right? It's encouraging our students to make the connection between the artwork, whether it's theater or a novel or a sculpture, and how that is being reflected in our society. And what's so cool is that we released this one, Michelle?
I think in like June or July is when we uploaded it to the website.
Yeah. And how many times has it been downloaded?
like a couple hundred, and I'll text Paul. I'll be like, did you see our numbers? Like,
yeah, it's really exciting.
They are downloading our text in the Philippines and India, and it is just very exciting.
Yeah.
So along with our text, you know, when we were trying to find all of these resources, of course, the search brought up a lot of other information that was not OER, but that could also be useful in the classroom, you know? So as we were kind of developing these topics, these teachers were finding all these other resources, YouTube videos, links to other websites, other information that the teachers could use with the lesson. So in addition to the textbook, it just kind of made sense to create a teacher companion to go with it, because there was so much other information that I wanted the teachers to have. So each teacher companion, we have the outlines and all the topics covered in the textbook, right? So they could see what pages go with what. We have a list of essential questions and objectives for the English teachers and the humanities teachers to follow. We have some vocabulary that showed up in the text that they might want to go over with their students. There's an area for making connections, because in the humanities course, we really want them to make connections between the different disciplines. And then a huge list of everything else that we found that was not OER, but that the teachers could use in their classrooms, right? Because educational fair use. And then lastly, our next steps.
Yeah.
So we have big goals.
We do. I mean, so you know, we have a good working text that we mixed along with the four college and our faculty members, and we're going to pilot it this fall. So we're actually meeting with all the humanities faculty on Monday, and they are going to be using it this fall. And hopefully we're going to, you know, get some really important information about what's working well, what are they missing, are there chapters we need to rethink? And so more than likely at the end of next semester, of this semester rather, we will be looking at our text and making some changes to it.
And that's the beauty of OER. It's like, you can just edit it. If this isn't working, we'll take it out. If there was a topic you taught and it wasn't in there, we can add it in.
Yeah.
It's beautiful. And hopefully we can, right now I said it lives on the website. We really want it to live in something called Manifold, which gives teachers ability to like annotate, right? And they can highlight things, and it's just more user, you can interact with the text more as opposed to it just living on a website.
Yeah. And so it's going to be really exciting to see what happens. And we encourage you to look at it too. So if you can't find it, email us. Oh, that's really interesting. Is our contact information in the
next one?
Mm-hmm. Oh, you've got, oh, cause you're so smart. Yeah. Michelle did this live. So feel free to reach out to us and we'll be happy to share you the link to get to our text.
Yeah. So this is what Kingsborough, here's our little Kingsborough on the beach. And here's our emails. But the most important thing we want and hope that you got from this presentation is that if we can do it, and we didn't know anything.
You can do it too. I mean, the goal of our presentation was really to talk about our process, to introduce to you the process we went through, pitfalls, things that we learned, and then to leave you with the idea that you can that you can do this too. And the other thing that I didn't mention is that the course that we are coordinating, it is preparing these students for college. I mean, it is a college class. But these students are still in high school, so they're kind of dealing with a college class in a high school culture. OER is the way of the future. When we first in the theater arts program started our OER, one of the main reasons was because of cost. Our students cannot afford a $200 textbook. This is free. And that is, it is the right thing to do for the planet, for our students. And so there's going to be more and more OER texts coming about. And so what Michelle and I have done with the humanities class is it's another way of preparing our students for that, you know, experience. So when they get to college, they're not like, where's my book? So we were really proud of that. So you can do this. You can totally do this. And we encourage you to do it. And we're excited for you to try it. And we feel free to reach out to us if you have any other questions.
And thank you for joining us.
Yes, thank you. And enjoy the conference. And we'll see you soon. All right. Bye-bye.